everyone, I'm Sadashiv Rao and welcome to Sada Learning Hub. Today's session, we are going to learn web application security for client certificate authentication. If you see here, there is a different security models are available in the declarative security model. These are a basic authentication or digest authentication and form-based authentication and client certificate authentication. In the previous videos, I'm discuss about basic authentication and form-based authentication and digested authentication. If you want, just go through my previous videos. Now, in this video, I'm going to cover about client certificate authentication. Before going to the client certificate authentication, I'm going to discuss about, first of all, what is the web application security. Now, before creating our application, we need to think about, are you giving a security to your web application or not first. Any application, any web application, security is a first and most need. If you want to provide a service of a servlet or a JSP, security service for a servlet or a JSP page, the only some authenticated users, then we need to apply the security for that servlet or a JSP. Now, you are created a web application. We need to provide some security for a servlet or a JSP. Definitely, we need to follow either one of these methodologies, models. To apply the security for the servlet or a JSP, we have a two approaches. Right, you are created a web application. But now this time your turn is we need to provide a security. If you want to provide the security to your web application, we need to go through the two ways. The first one is by the programmer and the second one is by the container. By the programmer means programmer only need to take care to provide the security. If a programmer is manually implementing the security code in a servlet or a JSP, then it is a programmatic security. A programmer can implement the security logic either in a servlet or a JSP directly by using the filters. Programmatic security increases the burden on the servlet programmer, so declarative security is applied. If you see, the declarative security means by the container. Declarative security means a container will apply the security by without manually writing the security logic by the programmer. Informs the web container about what servlet JSP of the application needs to the security. We configure the security related tags into a web.xml file. If you see, these are the tags we need to configure into our web.xml file. If you see, these are the security constraints. Under the security constraints, there is a two tags available, web resource collection and the authentication constraint. The web resource collection, we need to configure which servlets or JSP you are going to provide a security, and authentication constraints mean which role you are giving to access those resources, and the login config contains which authentication we are using. Are you using a basic or a form base or a client certificate? We need to mention in the login config tag. To providing the security for the resources is nothing but applying the authentication and authorization services. See here, we are providing some security to your servlets or a JSP. That is nothing but you are giving an authentication and authorization. Authentication is nothing but verifying of a username and password, and authorization is nothing but verifying your role. The set of roles with their username and passwords is combinedly called as a realm. This is about a web application security. Now, I'm going to discuss about one of the model in the declarative security, that is called client certificate authentication. If you see the client certificate authentication, this model is used to transfer the data between a client and the server over a secured socket layer. If you see, you are doing a payment by using a PayPal or something gateways. Those are using client certificate authentications only, handshaking. Means we are using the protocol as HTTPS. This model is also used to transfer the data between a client and the server over the security socket layer SSL. This means a model first, a server will send a certificates to the browser. Whenever you are requesting a servlets or a JSP, the server first it sends a certificate to the browser, means to the client. If the certificate is accepted, then the server allows the communication in a secure connection. If it is not accepted, communication is not allowed. If you see, if you are accepted, it is going to connect. If you are not accepted, it is not going to connect. If you see in the real time, third party certificate authority creates the security certificates for the data transfer using RSA algorithm, means revised Sober Adelman algorithm. If you see, if you are using a Paytm, if you are using any gateways, those are providing a third party certificates to do these transactions. To create a local certificate, we can use a key tool given by the JDK. JDK is also given by one key tool that will use it to generate a certificate. See here, the client certificate authentication is nothing but we are creating, or a third party is creating a certificate and put it into a server. Whenever you are requesting to that particular servlet or a JSP which is providing by the security service, The container will send to you a certificate to you. If you are accepted the certificate, further communication is going. If you are not accepting the certificate, the connection is going to closed. Now I will show how to create the certificate and how to configure into our server. And all those things I will show you. Now I'm creating a simple project, and now I'm going to create a simple certificate. I will show you how it is going to work. Here thing is, we can use any application to do this job. Now I'm going to create a first, I'm going to create the certificate. After that, I will show you in the project. Now, this is the project, this is the process to create a certificate. See, to create the certificate, JDK is given one tool called key tool. Key tool. We can use the key tool, we need to pass the parameters gen key. Key tool. Gen key space hyphen alias space test test one. This is our name. Which one you want, we can put it space hyphen. This is the alias name, is the test one, and key ALG means key algorithm. Which algorithm I am using? RSA. If you see here, key tool, what I am saying, generate key hyphen alias, what I am giving is alias name is test one. After that, I am using key algorithm is RSA algorithm. Now it is asking enter the key store password. I am giving the key store password is SADASIVARAO. Now it is asking re-enter SADASIVARAO. Now I'm pressing enter. It is asking the first name. Just I'm giving a Sada. It is asking the organizational unit. EDUCATION. It is asking organization. SADALEARNINGHUB. Sada Learning Hub. It is asking the location. TENALI. It is asking the state. Andhra Pradesh. It is asking the country code. India. It is asking everything is correct. Yes. Now it returns if some key password. Enter key password for test 1. Sorry, I am going to again. Here the step is missed. Now if you see the key store is created. I'm going to create once again. CLEAR. Clear. Shit. I'm going to close this one. CMD. Now key tool hyphen gen key hyphen alias test 1 hyphen key ALG space RSA. It is asking the password SADASIVARAO. Again SADASIVARAO. After that it is asking the first name Sada, and it is asking organizational unit EDUCATION. It is asking the organization SADALEARNINGHUB. It is asking location TENALI. It is asking state AP. It is asking India. Yes. Now it is asking the password again SADASIVARAO. Now it is asking re-enter the password SADASIVARAO. Now I am pressing enter. If you see, the certificate is created successfully. Now I will show the certificate is created successfully or not. See, this is my .keystore file. This is the my certificate. If you see here, this is my certificate. If you see, just now it is created 8:43. Now the time is 8:43. Time is also 8:43. Now keystore file is created. The next step is I need to configure my keystore file into a Tomcat folder, Tomcat directory. I'm going to my Tomcat directory. I'm opening the servers.xml file. In the servers.xml file, there is a HTTPS port is available. Control F, HTTPS. If you see here, this is my HTTPS port. This is my HTTPS port. We need to see, we need to configure here HTTPS in port. We need to give the path of this keystore file. See here, I am giving SSL enabled. See here, means client certificate authentication means SSL socket layer, secured socket layer. Means I am saying that just enable secured socket layer. Client authentication is false and key store file. Where is the key store file? I am putting the key store file is in this place. If you see, my key store file is generated into my local directory C colon users Sada. In the same place, I am C colon users Sada and the key store file. Key store password. Whatever the password you are given while generating your certificate, that password we need to give at here. Why? Because we need to verify it in while sending. That's why you need to give password at here. This is the maximum threads we need to create for the HTTPS port. This is the port number. This is the protocol HTTP 1.1. This is the scheme HTTPS protocol, and secured is true, and SSL protocol is TLS. This is the way we need to configure into your SSL certificate, means client certificate, into your Tomcat server server.xml file. After that, we need to go into the Tomcat users.xml. We need to configure your username and password and the role at here. Now I'm going to create a one dynamic web project. See here, I'm creating a simple web project at here. This is my simple web project. In this simple web project, I'm creating a client authentication servlet. This is my client authentication servlet. In this client authentication servlet, I'm writing that it is accepting the get method. After that, this is the client certificate error. This client login page. This is the web.xml file. See here, we can apply the client certificate authentication. We can apply it in basic authentication, or we can apply it in form based authentication. It's not at all a problem. Just here I'm using the form based authentication to apply the client certificate authentication. If you see here, I'm using the form based authentication. I'm configured my servlet. After that, I'm configured my security constraint. In the security constraint, which servlets or JSP you are going to give a security, and after that it is asking the role. After that, we need to configure in the login config. If you see in the form based authentication, we need to create a customized login page and the error pages. All those I am configured at it here. That's okay, fine. Next, this is my login page. This is my in this login page, we need to follow the three principles. That is J underscore security underscore check for the form action. For the username, we need to configure J underscore username, and the password we need to configure J underscore password. This is the error page. We can customize it anything. This is the servlet. This is about in the project folder. This is the project folder, and coming to your server side settings, we need to changes in the Tomcat users.xml file. We need to add roles and responsibilities, roles and the username and password. And coming to the server, we need to configure whatever the certificate you are created. That certificate we need to configure into the server.xml file in the connector port HTTPS. Now I'm going to run this example how it is going to work. See here, dot right click, run as, run on server. I'm clicking on the next, I'm clicking on the finish. If you see, my application is running. Now I'm giving the port number is 844. This is my port number 8443. And the protocol is HTTPS protocol, and I'm hitting URL pattern is, I'm giving security to this only. That's why I'm giving the URL pattern at here. This is my URL pattern. Now I'm pressing enter. See here, this is the security alert. Means whenever we are hitting servlet, means here servlet, I am giving a security. whenever you are hitting the servlet, it is asking to accept the security. In the client certificate authentication model, whenever you are contacting the server, the server container will send to you the certificate. If you are accepted that certificate, it opens the secured socket layer connection. If you are not accepting the certificate, it is going to fail. It is doesn't open the any connection. Now this time I didn't accept the any certificate. If you see this certificate, just now this is I am created this certificate issued to Sada, issued by Sada. If you see the details, this is the versions and all those things. If you see issue here Sada and Sada Learning Hub and valid from 3 days. See here I am public key is RSA and using all those things. If you the certification path and all those things. Now this is I am only the created certificate. If you want to accept this certificate, it is open to the secured socket layer connection. If you are not accepting the certificate, it doesn't open any connection. It is gives the 404 error itself only. Now I press no. See here. It is saying that there is a problem with the website security certificate. It is mentioned clearly there is a problem with a website security certificate. You are not accepted the certificate. That's why it is saying that this problem with this web security certificate. If you are accepted this certificate, now again I'm going to see I'm accepting the certificate. See clear. I'm accepted the certificate. Whenever you are accepted the certificate, it returns the username and password page. Now here onwards, it is going to execute form-based authentication logic. Whenever we are entering the form-based authentication, it is going to the container, and the container, it checks the values, whatever username and password and role, it checks into the Tomcat users.xml. If both are valid, it is going to execute servlet. If it is not, credentials are wrong, directly it is moving to the error page. Now I am entered the wrong credentials. See here, it is moving to the error page. Sorry, your username and password are not correct. Now I am moving to the this one. Why? Because it is the client certificate. That's why again it's not possible. Now I am coming to the here. Again I am going to hit on this one. See here, already your browser certificate is accepted. That's why again and again it is not asking. Now I am asking the proper credentials at here. Now it is moving to the success page. It's not a page, it is executing the servlet get. Whatever the get method you are written into the servlet page, it is going to execute this get method. See here, page successfully displayed. There is the username is something and the type is clients form-based authentication. Why? Because here we are using the form-based authentication on top of I'm using the client certificate authentication. I'm using at a time two authentication. One is client certificate authentication and another one is form-based authentication. These are the two authentication I am using. If you see, if you are executing one more time, now I'm accepting I did this yet here. This is the new browser. I am entering here. See here, it is asking your connection is not private. Automatically some system information page content. If you see in advance, if you accept this certificate and all those things. See here. Now the browser is accepted the certificate. That's why it is showing it here. If you are entering everything is proper, it is going to take, otherwise it is moving to the error page. Now I am entered the right credentials. That's why it is showing the success page. This is the way to execute a client certificate authentication model, and this is the way to create a local client certificate authentication. The JDK is providing a one tool to create a certificates for your local setting, checking. In the real time, the third party is giving to create the third party is give it to you for the certificates. Now this time I am explaining with the local for JDK is providing key tool to generate the certificates. That is the tool I am generating a simple certificate. I am configured into my server in the server.xml in the HTTPS port. After that, I'm using the form-based authentication. We can use it in basic authentication also. It's not give it anything wrong. It will be executed fine. Now, this is the way to execute a form-based authentication into your application. Thank you guys. Thank you.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel SAD.LearningHub because we have many sessions that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.